Welcome to Mailbag Monday. Tonight, accompanied by Tipsy Cow Milk Stout. A dark malt character of coffee and chocolate notes is balanced by lactose, lending it an added body and sweetness. And there's a joke about cow tipping on the back of there, but we'll just leave that alone. That is quite nice and roasty and malty and things. Oh, look, it's a bunch of mail, including one from one of you guys. At least I assume that's who that's from. It doesn't say, and it just came from China. So this first thing here is 2P, 3P, 4P, 5P, 50. And it rattles. It is an assortment of connectors. These are another assortment of JST connectors. The males look like they solder onto boards, intend to anyways. Where's a piece of circuit board here? There's just a random bit. Yeah, that will solder on there nicely, okay. Where'd that come from there? And then the females, we have the little crimpy pins here. Yeah, these little crimp pins here. I think they should work with the crimpers that I've got, I hope. And as we saw, since they fit into a breadboard or a circuit board, they are standard 0.1 pitch. Okay, and in 2, 3, 4, and 5 pin variety. They are similar, but not exactly the same as this assortment that I got a few weeks ago. This is cable to cable style, but will they meet up with each other? Looks like they just might. The latches are different though. See, these white ones have these little arrowy latch kind of things, and the black ones use that kind of a latch. Okay, still, it's good to have a variety. One box JST-XH kit, 2, 3, 4, 5 pin XH 2.54 millimeter terminal housing, PCB header wire connectors. I got these from Wonderful Buying 36588. Back when I bought them, I paid $5.44 with free shipping. Currently, as many of them, they're not shipping to Canada, or they're doing it with horrendous shipping charges. I ordered these back in March and they took 70 days to get here. They're rated at 1 amp, either AC or DC, 125 volts, either AC or DC, very wide temperature range, 100 meg ohm minimum. Cool. All right, next in this neat little yellow package, it says PC drive. Nothing else on the other side. Apparently they sell Raspberry Pi and Arduino stuff. eBay PLC Industry was the seller. Okay. Oh, this came from Germany. Wow. What is it? Oh, is that a Peltier? I think that's one of those Peltier temperature device thingies. So how these things work, actually there's two different ways that you can use them. The typical way, or what they're often used as, you put voltage into here, positive and negative, and one side gets hot and the other side gets cold. If you put a heat sink on the one side, the hot side for instance, and blow that heat away, then you can use the cold side for refrigeration. That's how the Coolatron branded coolers work and things like that. I just wanted us to play with it just because it's a neat piece of technology. One piece TEC112706 supports multi-stage refrigeration chip. TEC112706 free shipping from PLC-Industry. Okay, that's what it said on the card too. They say it ships from China/Hong Kong/Taiwan, but mine came postmarked from Germany and it got here in 18 days, which is pretty damn impressive. What do we have down here? Pictures, whole bunch of them, brand, model, no other information. Huh. Ah, here's some other sellers that have it. And they all call them 12 volts. Okay, that's what I need to know. So I guess let's try this and see if it works. got this set for 12 volts and 1 amp. I'm not sure how much it's actually going to draw. Power it on and it's already current limiting. And the back side is getting hot and the front side is getting noticeably cold. Wow. And that's only drawing, okay, that's drawing a full amp, but it's pulling it down to only 3 volts. Wow, let's shut that off. Do I have anything that can measure temperature around here? Not really. But that was noticeably getting cold to the touch on the lettered side. And it was almost too hot to touch on the blank side. Well, that's cool. Hmm. So if I put a heat sink and a way of getting rid of the heat on the hot side, and put that on the cold side, that could be an interesting project. All right, next thing in, we have 10 pieces, 12 millimeter Piezo 12 millimeter wire. Could it be Piezo something or others? Oh, they're just tiny little guys. Yes, these are Piezo discs. Piezos are another interesting little material or device. So a piezoelectric crystal is a type of crystal that, again, works in two different ways. You can either apply an AC voltage to the leads and you'll get mechanical vibration out of them. In other words, they become a speaker. Or you can mechanically vibrate the disc and it will create a small voltage out of here. So you can use it as a microphone or something like that. And that is the exact principle that this little guitar pickup I got a few weeks ago works on. There is inside here a slightly larger one of those. At least I assume it's slightly larger just because of the size of it. But so I could use these as guitar pickups or something like that. Or microphones. Or one thing I've seen them used for is embedded in a block of just cast silicone and used as a drum trigger to trigger a drum sample. Those would be fun to play with. 10 pieces, 12 millimeter piezo element sounder sensor trigger drum disc plus wire copper new. Got these from CA Electronics 8. Currently they're selling for $1.88, which is what I paid for them. And at the moment they've got almost $5 shipping. It was free shipping back in February when I ordered these. And they took 43 days to get here. And in the product description, absolutely nothing else to say. Let's just play with one of these for a second. I've got it connected up to my scope. Scope set to 0.2 volts per division vertically. If I just tap on this guy, you can see it's bouncing pretty well. It's going right off the screen, which is pretty much a volt peak to peak when it's going right off the screen. Wow. So you could pretty easily use that to trigger some kind of an input, or with a more subtle application like the guitar pickup, you could just use it in contact with the guitar body. And I got a bunch of them to play with, so that should be interesting. Expansion board module. Woohoo! Oh, that looks like it's a couple of 7-segment LEDs. Yeah, I have been stocking up on these with slightly bent pins even. Yep, a couple of 7-segment modules. That sticker's kind of annoying. I'll have to figure out which ones these are. Well, I'll probably figure it out pretty quickly just by throwing some voltage on them. Might as well use the current limited little LED tester. So the middle pin is the common pin on this kind of unit. So I think that... Aha! It's a blue one. Okay. And what do we got here? Positive, so it's common anode. Okay. 0.56, 1.8, 0.36, 0.5 inch, 1347 segment, digit common cathode / anode LED display. Basically, they got a bunch of different things in this listing. From CZB6721960, bought from them a bunch of times. I chose the half inch 7 segment blue. And I did actually pay $1.34 for this, but it was free shipping way back in February and I ordered them. Package content, 2x7 segment, 3-digit LED, I'm not sure exactly, blue, anyways, common anode, yeah. I don't know, what else do you want to say about it? There it is. And the last thing today, which is a surprise to everybody except for one of you guys, this is LED module LED. Let's see what's going on in here. Ah-ha-ha! This is... ooh, a 4-module wide one. Okay. Let me just get back into here. So these things you can get as individual modules, which is what I've got there. I've got 3 of them. Or you can get them prefabulated into a 4-wide like this guy is. So now then the question is, what type are these? Are the, what color are they? Oh no. Oh, that's just loose. Okay. That's intended to be loose. Fine. No panicking. There we go. Okay. I think I'm going to have to, maybe power this guy up and just see what color these are. All right, so here I've got it connected up based on the pins that I put into the script. The chip select is pin 10, clock is pin 11, and the data is pin 12. Okay, so this is the same sketch that I use on my scrolling sign. I've just changed the pins to make more sense on a nano rather than the AT Tiny that's inside the sign. So I'm going to use pins 10, 11, and 12. And yeah, this is, these matrices are based on the MAX7219 chip. There should be one of those behind each of the little LED panels. And for those that are curious, this is based on this right here. If you want to go and take a look, also there's another good one that Ivan from brainybits.com has, which is pretty similar to this as well. Anyways, that's just software, whatever. Let's play. Flip this guy over and get some power on the USB. Oh, this one runs sideways from how my other one runs. Okay. I wonder if there's something in that sketch that changes that. Hang on. Well, some time has passed and I've been tinkering with a bunch of different example code that I've hunted down for this thing. And so far, all the code that I've found either addresses this as graphics, kind of like this little test code is doing right now, or is expecting them, the cascade through them, to be going this way. So each module rotated, which is how this one back here is. I haven't been able to find some good code that works consistently well, that's got them lined up exactly like this. This is another example. That is supposed to be hello on the screen. Let me just type A, B, C, D. And it shows up like that. There's just A, but if I type 2 letters, it goes all funky and weird like that. So, again, you guys know me well enough by now. You know that code is nowhere near my strong suit, which means I'm going to experiment with this off camera and maybe do another video about it in the future, just with the different options and things. But thanks to whoever sent this thing, this is going to give me something interesting to play with and experiment with and expand my mind. Well, that was another interesting Mailbag Monday. like to thank whoever it was of you sent this matrix. It's going to be some interesting experimenting and playing. The rest of this is, you know, these connectors are going to be shop stock. These LED 7 segments are going to be shop stock for just future experiments. Back a few months ago when I was doing, what was it, the DIY guitar tuner, I realized that I had almost no 7-segment display, so I ordered a whole bunch of them. So this is, I think that's the last of them to arrive. These piezos, I was intrigued when I ordered this little guitar pickup, so I figured I better get some raw piezos to play with. And that Pelchi, well, again, it's something I've never played with, so I figured I'd grab one just to see what I can do with it. Thanks, as always, for watching. Thanks to my Patreon supporters for helping me buy this stuff. Thanks to Anonymous Donor for sending that in. I will talk to you all later. Cheers.